The fact that the Constitution, again, there's no express grant of habeas in the Constitution. There's a prohibition against taking it away. But it's never been the case. I'm not aware of a Supreme
Court. Wait a minute. The Constitution says you can't take it away except in case of rebellion or invasion. Doesn't that mean you have the right of habeas corpus unless there's an invasion or rebellion?
I meant by that comment, the Constitution doesn't say every individual in the United States or every citizen is hereby granted or assured or the right to habeas. It doesn't say that. It simply says the right of habeas corpus shall not be suspended except by...
You may be treading on your interdiction and violating common sense, Mr. Attorney.
And, Mr. Attorney General, just so that I want to make one thing very clear in this habeas corpus.
Sir, your mic? I can't hear you.
I want to make one thing very clear in the habeas corpus, and we can go back and forth what the case held or anything else. I feel that the Congress of the United States and the administration made a horrible mistake last year in a very short period of time and debate, basically undercut the writ of habeas corpus, the great writ. There were those who talked about 9/11, why they were doing it. I talked about the year 1200 and 15, I believe it was, when it first came into our concept. But the great writ of habeas corpus was done horrible damage by the Congress and a law the President signed last year. I just want to put everybody on notice. As chairman of this committee, I will do everything possible to restore all the rights under the writ of habeas corpus that were there before we passed the legislation we did, legislation I voted against. I'll make every effort to restore it. I just want everybody to know that.